Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to be painting this black boxer. You can look in the description box for all of the colors that you'll need, all of the paint brushes that you'll need, and it's going to be a fairly simple palette. So just look in the description box for all of the materials. I'm going to be painting on an 11 by 14 canvas panel. If you need the pre-sketched canvas, in the description box will also be a link to my website where you can buy that. So let's get started. So to start, I want to use a big flat brush or filbert brush, the biggest one you have, because we have a lot of stuff to cover and it'll just go a lot quicker if you have a bigger brush. But if you don't have one, just use whatever brush you have, the biggest one you have, just so you can cover as much of the canvas at a time as you can. So we're gonna go into our titanium white, a little bit of raw umber, a little bit of phthalo blue. So we're making this gray color. I want a little bit more white. I want it to be a light gray color. It'll have a bluish tint to it. And we're just going to cover the whole background with this color. And like always, I'm not too crazy with the backgrounds. I want to focus more on the painting. And as you get more comfortable with doing the painting portion of it, you can experiment with backgrounds and things like that. And in that mixture, when I reloaded my brush, I got a little bit more blue than I did the first time, but that's okay. I tend not to get all stressed out about the background. And again, I'm going to try to remember at the end to go over this background again so we can just get it all covered. I love this gray. I'm just mixing more of that color. And again, that was titanium white, little raw umber,
and a little phthalo blue. I add the raw umber just to tone it down a bit so it's not so blue. But you can still see a little twinge of blue in there. So it's not like a born gray color. Okay. Whatever is left on my palette, I'm just going over these areas again with it. I'm just using whatever's left on my palette to go over it again. Not using too much water because it'll just lift the paint. Okay. And you can rinse your brush out. And we'll set that one aside. And we'll get our medium flatter filbert. And I want to get in all of the shadowed areas. I want to, all of the darkest areas in this painting, which are going to be pretty dark. So we're going to go into our black and a little bit of raw umber. Make a pretty dark color and just follow along with what I'm doing. I'm going to put in all of the darkest areas first. So I'm just lightly brushing this in all of the dark areas. Okay. Okay. Some more of that color down here. And remember, when I'm going around his muzzle like this, even though I'm using a bigger brush, if you apply lighter pressure, you'll get a smaller line. So if you don't press too hard, you can get a thinner line. But if you don't feel comfortable with that, you can use a smaller brush to go around this muzzle. And some more color down here. Here. Okay. Some more over here. Okay, and now we can work on this top here. And again, on this part, you can use a smaller brush if that helps. I find it easier to, instead of looking at the whole painting or the whole reference picture, I try to focus in and hone in on small sections at a time. That way I won't get overwhelmed with everything that's going on and everything that I need to do for the painting. I try to hone in on these little sections. So right now I'm not looking at anything else other than what I'm actually painting, which is these dark areas, and I'm even focusing on the little sections that I'm painting at a time. I'm not worried about what's going on down here right now. I'm only worried about what I'm actually painting at the time, so I don't get overwhelmed. And I find that that helps me to stay focused. It helps me to, you know, compartmentalize and not get so bogged down with like details at this point. I'm just blocking in this darker color wherever I see it in my reference photo. Being a little precious right here. Just follow along with what I'm doing. Then we're going to go around. There's a big block of dark color down here. Get all these little dark areas done. Okay. All right, so it's looking good so far. We still have a lot of work to do. But like I said, we're breaking it down into little areas that we can see. And we can digest a little bit better when we're focusing on just little areas. So we're going to rinse this brush out. And we need to move on to a smaller brush for some of this, for some of the muzzle here. We just need a little bit more control. So we're going to go to our small round. Okay, but we're still using the same color mixture, which is the black and the raw umber mixture. Okay, so this is dry, so I can lean my arm on it now. We're just going around. We're still putting in the darkest areas. Just need a little bit more control right here. Okay. Put some of this color in here. It'll get covered up with some lighter color, but that's okay. We need that background color in there. That black background darkness. Go here. Okay. I always say if you like painting, you have to really learn to love the process, because some of this stuff is really tedious, and you have to really just fall in love with your process for painting, to get the patience to do all of this, kind of background work. It's pretty tedious, but it's all worth it. Okay. We're still using our small round. And we're gonna get the eyes in here. This is typically my favorite part of doing pet portraits and wildlife painting, is getting their eyes in there. Like, their eyes are so expressive, and I love trying to get it just right. It just brings the whole painting to life when you get these eyes in here. And again, this is not straight black. It's a mixture of black and raw umber. All right. I'm going to go over to the other eye now. Okay. So now we're going to leave the eyes alone. We want what we've done so far to dry before we move on to adding the color of the eyes. I'm just going around and just lining the rest of my sketch with this black and raw umber mixture. Okay. And I'm going to do that over here too. Just lining the head with this mixture. Okay. And you can rinse your brush out. Okay, we're going to work on some of the highlighted areas. So because this is a black dog, the highlighted areas are kind of like grayish mixtures. I tend to not just mix black and white to make a gray. I like to have more dynamic grays. So for instance, for this one, we're going to use a little bit of raw umber, a little bit of phthalo blue, and a little bit of white, almost like the background that we did, but just a little bit darker. And when I'm doing other paintings, I like to mix more dynamic grays by using whatever's on my palette. So for instance, if my painting has like a lot of pink in it and pink is on my palette, I'll mix that with green and a little bit of white to make a more dynamic gray, because those are complementary colors and you can get a gray from that. And it'll keep the painting a little bit more cohesive if you're using the colors that are already on your palette and you don't want like flat gray colors. So like I said, we're gonna mix, we mixed raw umber, a little bit of phthalo blue, and a little bit of white to make this gray color that's going to be kind of like a highlight. I might want a little bit of more raw umber, a little bit more raw umber, a little bit more white. So this is like the next dark color that I see. And we're just going to get that in there. You see how it's a gray color. And these are going to be our little highlighted areas. And we'll even add more highlights to some of these areas using that same mixture, just a little bit more white. Just follow along with what I'm doing, where I'm putting these colors in it. Okay. Okay. And we're going to add just a little bit more white to that. We're going to get it even a little lighter. And we're going to go up here. And I know it's kind of blending in with the background, but we're going to add even more highlights, and you'll be able to kind of distinguish from the background and the dog. Okay. So already we're getting some detail in without even trying to, just by putting colors in the right places and things like that. We're getting the illusion of lots of detail when we haven't really done much. Okay. And if you still have some on your palette, we're going to add even more white to that. It's going to look almost pure white with just a twinge of bluish color to it. And we're going to put that in here. I'm gonna put that right here and over here and put it down here. Okay. I added even more white to it. Just follow along with what I'm doing. Just getting all of this colored in. Just getting all of this blocked in, basically. Okay, it's looking good. And put a little bit over here. Bit over here. A little bit in here. Just dry brushing this in. There's not very much paint. There's not any water on this brush at this point. Okay. And you can rinse your brush out. We're going to get our small round. And we're going to go into our raw umber. I'm going to work on this little ear over here. And this raw umber is going to go in like so. And then with that raw umber mixture, we're going to mix a little bit of the crimson with it. And white, titanium white. I'm gonna mix a little bit more white. We want it really light, maybe a little bit of raw sienna. To get this light color. I'm gonna go around like this. On the inside of the ear. We're going to rinse our brush out. We're going to take our black. We kind of lost that black that was around here and just line the outside of that ear. I don't have much black on my brush and white to get a little gray. Okay. Dried my brush out and we're gonna go back in to the nose. We're gonna work on this nose a little bit. And we're just using just black right now. There's not much on my brush, so I'm just going to dry brush over this area so it's not so light. Just dry brushing. Okay. Looks good, guys. We're going to go back to working on the eyes a little bit. And we're going to go into our burnt sienna. A little bit of raw umber. That was too much raw umber. So I'm going to make another one over here. So burnt sienna, a little bit of raw umber. You're going to see a little bit of a reddish tint to it. And we're going to put in the eye color here. It looks really dark on camera, but on your canvas, you'll see it's like a reddish brown color. I'm going to put it on the other eye. Okay. And we're going to add a little bit of white to that mixture. It's going to look like a little cream color. We're going to put that in right here. Okay. I lost a little bit of the black that we had put in. So I'm just going to put it back. Okay, it's too wet for me to put it back now, so I'm just going to let it dry. I'm going to let that dry, and then I'll go back over it. Okay, so what else do we need to do? What else can we do? We're going to go back with our medium brush and we're going to go just into our black now. I'm just going to add some, we'll add some little we're not completely covering that the black and raw umber mixture. We're just adding some black to it just dabbing it in. So it's not straight black. Just lightly brushing over some of those darker areas. Brushing in some of this black over those areas. A little bit. Okay, and you can rinse your brush out. now we're going to get our small round or liner brush. And I'm going to put the black back on the eye now that this is dry. Remember earlier, I had taken out too much of the black. So if you didn't do that like I did, don't worry about this step. I'm just going back and putting this black back in. Okay. And we're going to go into our raw sienna. And we're going to put a little bit of that color in the eye as well. And also on this eye. Okay. My brush is dry now. I had a little bit too much water on my brush when I did the black, so I'm taking some of that water away. Now we're going to get a little bit of the raw sienna, a little tad bit of white. Lighten it up quite a bit. And on this side of the eye, we're going to put that color in here. Don't cover up all of the black. And we're just going around the pupil of the eye with this lighter color. I took away a little bit too much of the black. So I'm just going to put that back in there. Okay. Now we're going to let those eyes dry a little bit more. You can rinse your brush out and get your smaller flat or filbert. You're going to get a little bit of white, a little bit of raw umber, a little bit of raw sienna. We're just going to put this in here. I think I want a little bit more raw sienna in that mixture. Where to go? There it goes. Just follow what I'm doing. I'm not covering up what color we have here already. I'm just adding a little bit of this color to it. Okay. And put some of that color over here. Some of that color down here. Just really light pressure. And we'll put a little bit of that color in here. And we'll put some of that color in here. And these are just light, quick strokes. Put a little more up here. Now we're going to get a little bit of white and raw umber, a little bit of phthalo blue, a little more white. I want this to be pretty light. And we're going to put this in here. And it's like a press and drag, press and drag. I think I want even more white to that. I'm pressing and dragging. We'll put some of that color in here as well. Also gonna put some of that here, a little bit here. Some up here. We're almost done with this painting, guys. Some over here. Just want a couple little highlights over here. And get some more white, just white. You don't have to rinse your brush out or anything like that. We'll use whatever color we have on the brush and just add white to it. Now we don't want to cover up all of the gray that we did down here. We're just dabbing the white in on this part. We're not completely covering the gray though. The gray is our contrast color, so we don't want to cover that all the way up. And I'm making sure not to make any straight lines or anything like that. I'm just dabbing this in to get the variations of like fur, and there's texture here. We don't want any straight lines. A little bit of the white here, just to highlight. Okay. Just gonna add a little bit of white throughout here. Not a lot, and my brush is very dry. There's not much on it. Very dry brush. There's hardly any paint on my brush now. I'm just dabbing this color in. Just scrubbing whatever is on my brush. Want to go get some of my black. I want to go back in here. Put some more black over here and up this way. Okay. And just follow along with what I'm doing. A little bit more here. Okay, a little bit more here. And the last thing we're gonna do is put a couple of highlights in the eyes, and then we'll be done, guys. So we're just gonna get a little bit of white I'm gonna add a couple little highlights. Around here, just a couple little dots. Okay, a little dot here. A little dot, a little bit there. Okay. And then we'll go over to this side and we'll a little bit there. And a little bit here. Maybe a little highlight here on the nose. Little highlights on the nose here. A little bit under the eye. Over the eye. Put a little bit too much. Okay. A little bit more black here. Okay, and that is it for our painting. If you have any questions or comments, leave them below. And I hope you enjoyed this video. And I'll see you in my next one. Bye.